Greetings, Microsoft Flight Simulator friends, and welcome to Patriot Six. This video is a request from one of the Patriot Six MSFS 2020 Senior Group members on Facebook. And by the way, if you'd like to become a member of that page, there will be a link in the description below. The requester wants to build a package where they can display the planes that they have, not only for himself, but the group member wants to share this package with friends so they could also see his collection of aircraft. And this is an easy thing to do, and I will jump right in and show you how to display your aircraft in your own package. I'm going to build this package using the aircrafts that have been specially built for me, and I wanted an iconic place to put it. Not that I'm ever going to use this, but I couldn't think of a more iconic place to put it than right here at the US Capitol. So if you're not familiar with building scenery, you will have a hard time doing this, because you need to understand the basics in building scenery. However, if you'll go to the description below, click on the See More button, there will be links there for the Facebook group, the Patriot Six YouTube channel. I'll put a link in for Discord, but the most important thing for new people is I'm going to put a link to a tutorial where I walk through all of the basics. And these tutorials will teach you all the basics it takes to get you ready to start building scenery. So you're free to watch this, but once you want to attempt this yourself, you need to know the basics. And now I will begin, and I have already built a package for this. So I'm going to go up to the developer menu, which, by the way, I am in developer's mode. I'm going up to the developer menu to editors, and I'm going to open the project editor. And I see the inspectors up, which I need the inspector. And as a reminder, you can always get to the inspector from the project scenery editor by going to view and ticking on the inspector. Now on the project editor, I'm going to open project, and the project editor navigated to the working scenery folder. That's the folder I used to work out of to build packages. And the package I created for this job is Patriot 6 Test Scene. I'm going to open it. Drop down to the bottom XML and open and wait for things to load in. And while things are loading in, I will tell you that I pre-built the initial package. Anytime you start a new scenery package and you get everything set up in the inspector, you must have a pre-built package to start working scenery. Again, all of that is covered in the tutorials. I'm going to go ahead and bring up the scenery editor, which has various windows that I need. Once again, those are covered in the tutorials. And I need for all the scenery library to load in and all of the scenery out here to load in, which takes a few minutes. Okay, I see that the scenery library has loaded in. That is all of the items in my scenery library. I'm going to drop down to the scenery BGL, tick on it, and load in editor. Okay, everything has loaded in. The scenery BGL has loaded in, along with all the items in my scenery library. And I guess I got a couple Secret Service agents here watching what I'm doing. So I'm going to be a good person. All I'm going to do is place some aircraft on the lawn of the Capitol. Nothing wrong with that, right? On the objects window, we're set for scenery. That's the default set. But your aircraft are going to be in Sim Objects. On the objects window, I want to select Sim Objects and go ahead and tick all and move into position. And it really helps if you know the title of your aircraft. So I do know I have a Longitude. And I typed in Longitude and it filtered everything down to Longitude. And the one I'm interested in is the one I had built for me. The Longitude of the New England Patriots. So I'm going to grab this and hit add and give it a second to spawn in. And at this point in time, it's in, and I can go ahead and position it wherever I want. Now the second aircraft is a PMDG 737, so I'm just going to type in PMDG. And now I'm going to have to sort through them. Here is the Patriots PMDG 737-700, and I'm going to add. And take it to mid spawn in. A little bit bigger aircraft. So I'm going to move it this way. And see how the planes are facing and see if they need to be adjusted. Looks okay. And lastly, I have a PMDG 900. Let me go through the 900ERs. And here is Patriot 6. And I'm going to add. Much bigger plane. Needs a little more room. So there's one last thing I'm going to do. Anytime I've ever added static aircraft before, they would always be sunk into the ground a bit. And each time that I've added them, it's been at an airport on a ramp. And once I would load the package up with the static aircraft, the aircraft would normalize and be sitting on the tarmac. The scenery here in Washington, D.C. has been manipulated. This is payware scenery. Often in payware scenery, they will build textures up above the ground. So I don't want to take any chances that these aircraft are trying to snap to the normal Asobo ground versus the payware scenery. So I'm going to raise each of these up to look normal, and hopefully that works out good in the package. I've got the 737-900 selected now, so over on the properties window, which if you don't have the properties window, you can get to it from the scenery editor by ticking view and ticking properties. I'm going to remove snapped ground on the properties, and I'm going to raise this baby up. Okay, that looks okay. Now let's do the same with the other two. I have the 700 now selected. I'm going to remove snap to ground from the properties and raise the 700 up. And get where I can see the wheels. If I wanted to rotate the plane forward, like this wheel's buried down a bit, you can do that by going to the rotate and changing this axis here, which is very touchy. And back to translate. I think that's close enough for an image. And lastly, the longitude. Remove snap to ground. Now I may come back, I may save this package and come back and these aircraft be hovering in the air. I really don't know. Hopefully not. Hopefully it'll be normal. I have a suspicion that this being payware, the aircraft are going to be sunken into the earth. Don't want that. So now, I feel pretty good about what we have here. I wish the longitude wouldn't do what it's doing. In terms of the colors going away when I get off of it, that's annoying. But, it is what it is. Okay, let's save the scenery down here on the scenery editor. And now I'm going back to the project editor. I'm going to tick off the BGL, and on the project, I'm going ahead and remove the properties. I don't need it. And I'm going to build the package. Good, the package is fine. We don't have any errors. And now I'm going to move it into the community folder. And let's bring up the good old community folder. And for those of you that use the add-on linker, as I do, you would want to pull up the scenery folder that you use. And this is the one I use for the add-on linker. But since this is just a test and for a video, I'm not going to put this in the add-on linker folders. I'm going to drop it in the community folder. And here is the working scenery folder. Here is the folder in which I built the test scenery. Let's open it up and go to packages and find the test scenery package. I'm going to copy it. And I'm going to paste it into the community folder. And here it is in the community folder. Now I'm going to restart the simulator and come back and look at the aircraft. Now that I've spawned into Washington, D.C., I'm going to pause the simulator. I'm going to hop in the developer camera, and let's see what we got going on. I see aircraft. Still just two Secret Service vehicles, so I guess I'm okay. And they look like they're sitting on the ground like I'd want them to sit. The longitude's a little bit annoying with the color going away, but I don't think there's anything I can do about that. If I zoom back far enough to take a snapshot, that's what I get. And there you go. That's how you can build a package to display your favorite aircraft, should you want to do that. So let's talk about how we share this package with friends. So that you can see what I'm doing, I'm going to change the viewing options of MSFS 2020. And I'm going to go from full screen to windowed. And now I could minimize MSFS 2020. And on the desktop, I'm going to right tick, new and folder. I'll name this Patriot Six Friends. Now the folder completed, so I'll move it out of the way. Back to Microsoft Flight Simulator. And here's the folder for Patriot Six Friends. And now I want to share the liveries. And since I use the add-on linker, I'll have to go to my scenery folders. If you don't use the add-on linker, you would go to your community folder. And I keep the liveries here in a global file. These are mostly items that I run all the time. Here is the livery for the longitude. So I can copy it over. Two of my aircraft are PMDG aircraft. That's a little bit complicated. My friends would have to own these particular aircraft. If they don't, I won't be able to share it, because what you're seeing here is my scenery, my community folder, my official folder. My friends will have a totally different official and community folder. But as long as they had the version of Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 that has a Cessna Citation Longitude, they'll be able to see this. Let me back up just a second and make a folder called liveries. I'm going to move the longitude livery inside the liveries folder. Then I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm going to call this the project. I'm going to open the project folder. I'm going back to the working scenery folder. I'm going to the folder that I made the project in Washington, D.C. Go to the package and copy the package and paste. Inside the Patriot Six Friends folder, I have the project and I have the liveries. And if you own PMDG products, you know how to export the liveries. If you have freeware you want to share, you would also place them in the liveries folder. For payware, your friends will have the same payware airplanes for them to be able to see them. Sorry about that, but that's just the way it is. Same thing with PMDG. Any freeware you can pop in here, but the payware, they have to actually own the aircraft for them to be able to see your aircraft. If you have a special livery, you would place it in here just like I did. And we can see there are two folders inside the folder, one for liveries, one for project. And I would just simply zip this folder and send it to my friends. So that's how I would set up the sharing folder. And I thank you for watching Patriot Six. If you're not a subscriber, I would appreciate it greatly if you subscribed. It helps feed the algorithm. A comment and a thumbs up is also very helpful. And if you don't know how to do the things I did, there is a tutorial series, as I mentioned a couple of times. You can find it in the description below, along with the chapters of this video, should you need to come back and revisit any of it. And again, thanks for watching Patriot Six. I will see you soon.